beginning of a pilgrimage into history, Pope Paul VI leaves Rome Airport on his precedent-shattering trip to the Holy Land. Even as he boards the plane, he creates a series of historical firsts. He is the first pope to fly, the first pope to leave Rome since 1809, and the first pope to visit the Holy Land in nearly 2,000 years. At the airport at Amman, Jordan's King Hussein becomes the first Arab ruler to receive a pope. The pontiff, a striking figure in white, seems to be a towering symbol of man's dream of the renewal of brotherhood among all sects and all races. The Muslim and the Catholic, the king and the pontiff, hands stretched across centuries of strife, clasped in the warmth of understanding and friendship. Patriarchs of the Eastern Rite Catholics join in the airport welcome. Not since the split with the Roman Church in the 11th century have the Orthodox Christians seemed so close to Western Catholics. The Pope's pilgrimage to the land of Jesus Christ and the birthplace of Christianity is to be 3 days of devotion at the most holy places in Christian history. From Amman, the Pope's motorcade carries him 54 miles to the ancient Damascus Gate at the walled city of Jerusalem. Here the throngs get out of hand as they press forward to greet the Pope. It's a scene of near hysteria and jubilation as the pontiff retraces the steps of Jesus along the Via Dolorosa, the way of the cross, the very streets that Christ walked on his way to Calvary, his crucifixion, and his death. Police are helpless. They can do little but slowly force a path through the crush as the Pope makes his way to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. This church is built on the traditional site of Christ's tomb. Here the Savior was entombed for 3 days until the miracle of Easter Sunday morning. Here Pope Paul celebrates the first of the masses he will read at sacred shrines during his pilgrimage. From Jordan, the Pope crosses into Israel to be greeted by President Zalman Shazar and other high Israeli dignitaries. The fortified boundary between Arab and Jew is breached for the Pope as he proceeds northward to Nazareth, where Jesus spent much of his early life. At the Church of the Annunciation, Pope Paul is to celebrate another Mass. This church commemorates the biblical story of the angel announcing to Mary that she will become the mother of Jesus. The pontiff wished to say Mass in Nazareth because of its association with the Holy Family of Joseph, Mary, and Jesus. From Nazareth, the cortege travels through the cypress-lined fields of Galilee to Tiberias. Here there are many historic sites for the pontiff to visit, but he has not the time to see them all. He does reach Tabiga and a church that commemorates one of the most beloved of biblical stories, the miracle of the loaves and the fishes. This is the Church of the Multiplication. The Sea of Galilee, where Christ signaled out Peter to be the first of the apostles, the Peter who first occupied the throne that has now come down to Pope Paul VI. After leaving Galilee, the Pope met with Patriarch Athanagoras, leader of the Orthodox Rite. Thus, Pope Paul ended his journey as he had begun it by again making history.